is Jeremy Fisher. My new record's called Goodbye Blue Monday.
Bubblegum and house parties when we stole your parents' rum and tried to screw everything.
We made the record in about 15 days. We did about 2 songs tracking and then 2 songs mixing a day. It went really fast. It was really high energy, you know. I got to play a lot of instruments on it. I got to play bass, accordion, keyboards, all the guitar parts, harmonica. It flowed really well, and so I'm happy with the way it sounds today because it sounds like a moment in time, you know.
Did I call your name? Did you hear me singing that song I wrote for you? You're so the same, but you're so different, I didn't recognize you.
I made 3 videos for this record for the songs Scar That Never Heals, Jolene, and Cigarette. And most notably is probably the video for Cigarette, because it got featured on the front page of YouTube and ended up going from sitting there for a month and getting a couple thousand hits to having 250,000 hits overnight, and then eventually, you know, 2 million or plus hits. I haven't checked lately, but it's had a whole lot. And the interesting story behind that is that all 3 of those videos I made at home, just on my laptop, their animation, stop motion animation, and I basically just learned, you know, on the internet how to do it myself, and I just had some time to kill, so I made the first one for Scar That Never Heals was a simple sort of pixelation with scratching on the screen and just me kind of goofing around in my apartment figuring out how to animate. The video for Jolene was sort of like figure skating on snow. We had 3 long days of snowfall last year, and so I just went out and taped myself running through the snow and gliding through the snow and stuff.
Don't cry for me, Jolene. Wipe your tears away. Been an orphan since I was born in. I've been dying since that day.
The video for Cigarette was a little more involved. It involved sort of live action animation, you know, real people, myself and a couple of my friends, and a little cigarette I made out of modeling clay. Animated it, made it into, gave it a personality and made it, you know, look sort of like it was looking for love in the world, and it was getting rejection everywhere, and in the end it finds its perfect match. So it's a simple little thing, but it was cool to watch it go from just something I made at home and uploaded onto YouTube to, you know, hit it going into the viral stage and getting passed around. And my friends would tell me that someone that I don't even know had, you know, emailed it to them. And that was kind of cool to watch that happen. The cool thing is that I can do it at home, and I can do it without sitting in a marketing meeting and having, you know, the input of a whole bunch of people. It's just really something that I made directly for the people who listen to my music. When you get 2 million hits, you know, on YouTube, those are people choosing to watch it, and it's a little more meaningful in that way.
Sweet relief, that's what you come and get from me. I give it up every time you want it. You got it, I'm burning down. It's alright, cause I'll be your cigarette.
What you're trying to do when you make a record is you want as many people to get a chance to hear it as possible. I'm going to Australia in a few days, so that'll be my first time touring down there. Hopefully Europe. I'd like to do some more touring on my bicycle. It's kind of exciting. I know that I'll be making music. I just don't know, you know, how I'll be making my living at that exactly. I feel successful. I mean, I don't have lofty goals of making a lot of money. I'd love to just see the audiences keep growing, and I'd love to just keep making music that I'm inspired by, and hopefully keep getting better at doing that.